In this video, I'm going to show you how to find the mean and standard deviation from a frequency distribution by using your graphing calculator. So this is a situation where instead of being given the raw data values, a bunch of data values, and being asked to find mean and standard deviation, you're given a frequency distribution table. So if you take a look, we have an example here. It's actually a sample of 100 babies born in a hospital. Notice that we are not given all the individual weights of the babies. We're given a frequency distribution table. So it tells us these different classes and how many babies were born in each class. So in order to estimate the mean of this frequency distribution table, what we need to do is find the class midpoints. So notice that the first class is 3 to 4.9 pounds, and that there are 5 babies that weighed in between those two amounts, 3 and 4.9 pounds. So what I'm going to do is find the class midpoint. I can do that using the calculator. Easiest thing would be to use your fraction bar and do 3 plus 4.9, which is the lower class limit, adding to that the upper class limit, dividing by 2. That's going to give us 3.95. That's why you have the 3.95 on the side. So there's a little bit of work that has to be done before you can use your calculator on this. I'm then going to do the same thing for all the other 4 classes that you see. Those are where the other numbers come from, the class midpoints. And again, what we're doing is basically estimating the weight of the 5 babies between 3 and 4.9 pounds by assuming that all of them are 3.95 pounds. Obviously, it is not an exact measurement, but it's all we can do when we're given a frequency distribution table. So once we have all our class midpoints, we're ready to use the calculator. We go to Stat and to Edit. And then what you'll see is that you want to put your class midpoints into one of the lists. So I put the class midpoints into list 1. And I'm going to put the frequencies that correspond to each of those midpoints in list 2. It doesn't really matter where you put them. You just have to remember where you put your class midpoints and where you put your frequencies. Once I've done that, as you can see I have, I go to Stat, over to Calc, and I choose one variable statistics. We have 100 babies here. That's what we're dealing with. For list, I'm going to put where I put the class midpoints. For frequency list, this is where I put list 2, because those are the frequencies of how many babies weighed for those different classes. So frequency list is list 2. And then I go down to calculate and I press enter. Notice right away, it's giving me a bunch of summary statistics for this frequency distribution table. Our focus here is simply on X bar, which is the mean from the frequency distribution table. As you can see, it's 7.67. So what your calculator has done is it's multiplied all the class midpoints by the frequencies, and then added those numbers together to get 767, and then divided by how many babies there were. In this case, there were 100. So that's where the 7.67 comes from, but your calculator does it for you. And then the standard deviation is here as well. And you can see the standard deviation is, there's 2 of them. Your calculator gives you sample and population standard deviation. We're told that this is a sample of 100 babies, so we want SX, that's the sample standard deviation given in the one variable statistics summary statistics function. And so we want the value of 1.88604658.4. That's going to be our standard deviation. That is in pounds as well. And that's how to use your calculator to find the mean and standard deviation from a frequency distribution.